Hey, what's going on, everyone? It's Vosk. I'm here with Tales of the VoskCoin YouTube channel, and today I'm here to talk to you about the Antminer A3. Did we actually hit 500 bucks a day? And all the soft pork, oh my god. Soft fork and hard pork drama. Let's get right to it. How much did I actually mine? I mined 8,750 Siacoin, which on the current rate of when I'm shooting this video, and the date would be January 24th, and it's about 4 p.m. I mined $350. Let me just double check. $349. $350. That's wild. And it would actually be a little bit higher because I have gone over the 24-hour mark, and where I took my initial, you know, hopeful, wishful projections of 500 almost-ish rounded up a day, if you saw my video yesterday. So this miner, the Antminer A3, is real. And the threat of a soft fork or hard fork from the SiaCoin developers is a very real threat. And I say threat because it's harmful. Threats are harmful. And you're like, oh man, that's just because you have an A3, blah, blah, blah. Well, I mean, yeah, obviously I have an A3. Obviously I wouldn't want my $2,000+ investment to go down the drain. So yeah, obviously. But on a more important note, I'm going to throw my opinion out here. I really try to just report on things and be unbiased as I can be. And, you know, let you decide after I bring you the facts. But I'm going to bring you an opinion here today. Do you think that invalidating Bitmain's ASIC miner is the right move? Whether or not you agree with Bitmain, and if you follow my work, you know that I don't agree with Bitmain. I'm not an advocate of Bitmain. I do not like Bitmain. I don't even like ASIC miners. Okay, so please understand that when I'm talking about this subject, I don't even like ASIC miners. I'm a GPU miner because of this very reason. But what do I know, right? I'm just some dude with a cute dog, right? I mean, it's probably sums me up. On June 22nd, 2017, David Vorek announced why they chose to make the ASIC miners, aka Obelisk, for the SiaCoin network. And they went on and on about how ASICs are the right move and GPU miners just hop around for profitability and so on. Okay, Bitmain crashed your party with ASICs. And now you don't like that they brought ASICs to your party. It doesn't work like that. If you fork the A3s off of your network, you are centralized. Don't ever call yourself decentralized. And look, if you'd like to do that, if that's what you want to do with your project, that's okay. I understand that. I'm not mad if you do that. I get it. But don't act like it's some heroic move. It's a money move. And everything's business, so I get that. But don't act like a hero when you're not one. Okay? So that's my two cents here. I don't like to be so opinionated here, but it's just ridiculous. You say, we want an ASIC miner. You take $2,500 for the batch one pre-order of the Obelisk SC1. $2,500. Looks like, I can't find the exact day. It's not really worth digging up, but somewhere between June and July, those went up. And I'm just pulling a number off the top of my head for a price around then. Bitcoin is probably like $2,000-$3,000. And let's take the crappy price of Bitcoin today, about like $1,100 last time I checked. So without doing a thing, you could have just bought Bitcoin and you would have at least times five your money on today's crappy rate. Guess what Bitmain does? They put up an ASIC order, and obviously some people abuse the system, and maybe there were deals behind the scene. I don't know. I don't work for Bitmain. I'm not paid by Bitmain for this video. I do know that I went on there and I was only allowed to order one. And that's all I wanted to order. And I ordered that miner. That miner was in my house within 7 days. 7 months is a lower amount of time than when the people who ordered the SC1 from Obelisk will receive their miners. You'll be waiting around a year for vaporware. Nothing's real until it's proven. People say that they bought the miner to support SiaCoin, and, you know, they weren't doing it for the profits. If that's true, if that's truly true, don't mine the Siacoin to your address. Mine the Siacoin to the developer's address. There's three main reasons that I got into cryptocurrency. One, I wanted to pursue a endeavor where I could work from home and give Tails a better life. You know, say whatever, sappy, whatever. I love Tails. She means everything to me. And I wanted to work on a project where I could be at home. She would never be crated up or alone or just whatever in the house. She would, at a minimum, at least have me to hang out with. Then I like the technology and the whole mission of crypto, the decentralization. You know, just had so much incredible benefits to offer. Even just the basically borderless peer-to-peer currency. The fact that some dude in, you know, South Africa can be like, hey, I want to buy your dog. And I'll be like, sure, it's only two Dogecoin. And click, click, Dogecoin is in my account and I can go ahead and ship them Tails and everyone can unsubscribe. Right. That's a very impressive feat. Try to do that with your bank. What a nightmare. I got charged like almost $50 to wire a USD wire to Canada. Wow, that was a great deal. And finally, of course, obviously, I got into cryptocurrency to make money. What's the point of getting into a project that's just going to suck all your time and money up? I'm already into cars. I already got a project like that. I need to get into a project that actually makes money. So at approximately 1 o'clock Eastern time, there was a huge issue that the rumor, FUD, whatever, is that the developers were testing some kind of soft fork to basically crush the Antminer A3s. Some people were telling me that their Antminer A3s were overheating. They were extremely worried. And I didn't focus on the heat of my miner. I was freaking out like, okay, I'm getting bricked. This sucks. And I went ahead and just started slamming restart on my A3. And fortunately, after a couple restarts, it synced back up and it was hashing again properly. But you can look on SiaMining, like right here. This is my miner. I've left it on the same spot so everyone can watch it for everyone that's curious. It's been in the description of my last couple videos, and it's going to be in the description of this video if you want to check out my miner and see, you know, how it's doing. Live readouts, you can see my earnings and everything else. In addition to that, I checked across the pool, and you can see here that all these other miners were also going down, and I was like, well, is SiaMining.com having a problem, or is this network-wide? Then I went to look at some other pools, for example, Luxor Tech, which on the topic of Luxor Tech, they posted a tutorial on their Twitter on how to sync up your Antminer A3 to their pool. And then they are the top names signed in this petition to fork the A3 miners off of their network to brick them. My point with Luxor was just that I looked at their pool and people were having the same hash rate issue on there as well as the other pools. So there's not too many pools. SciStats.info is a good website to get good readouts on all this stuff. I can't believe this kind of drama is taking place in one of the top cryptocurrencies. Anyway, that's my day one profits with the Antminer A3 and my take on the soft fork, hard fork, and really all the drama surrounding this. I'm gonna go ahead and post the link to this video when I post it into the Reddit in the description, and you can quickly watch it go to 0 points. It's gonna be a lot of downvotes. So, you know, we'll see. See what happens. I hope that I didn't offend anyone or didn't lose any subscribers on this piece, because I really try to bring, you know, fair, interesting, fun, factual, just videos to you guys. But, you know, at the end of the day, someone's got to come out here and make a statement, and I'm not afraid to make a statement for what I believe in. And if this is decentralized crypto, you know, it sucks. Bitmain crashed your party, but you've got to run with it. If you want to beat them, build a better miner. You don't just get to tell them they can't come to the party. So with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the VoskCoin YouTube channel. I'll be home.